Hello everyone, welcome back to Chemical Engineering and Aspen channel. As you know, these days we are focusing on the module of Chemical Reaction Engineering. So in this regard, we are bringing lecture number 20 for our valuable viewers. So in today's lecture, we will solve example number 5.1, which is related to the batch reactor. In our previous lecture on building block number 4, which is isothermal design, or chapter number 5 of this book, we have solved some equations for the batch reactor. And now it's time to solve an example related to the batch reactor design. So the problem states that it is desired to design a CSTR to produce 200 million pounds of ethylene glycol per year by hydrolyzing ethylene oxide. So the reaction is ethylene oxide hydrolyzation in the presence of a catalyst to produce ethylene glycol. However, before the design can be carried out, it is necessary to perform and analyze a batch reactor experiment to determine the specific reaction rate constant K. So if you look at these four lines, you can see that actually we want to design a CSTR, but while designing the CSTR, we are not given the parameter of K, which is specific reaction rate constant. So accordingly, we will use the batch reactor. We will run the experiments in the batch reactor to find the value of the specific reaction rate constant. And if you remember, in our initial lectures, I had already told you that batch reactor is usually used to provide some parameters as well. Because the reaction will be carried out isothermally, isothermally means inlet temperature, outlet temperature, the temperature will remain the constant. The specific reaction rate constant will need to be determined only at the reaction temperature of CSTR. Because if you remember our previous lectures, that K is a function of temperature. So accordingly, when temperature is constant throughout the system, it means that we have to just determine and the reaction conditions, because the temperature will remain constant at an isothermal system. At temperatures above 80 degrees centigrade, there is a significant byproduct formation, while at temperatures below 40 degrees centigrade, the reaction does not proceed at a significant rate. So accordingly, a temperature of 55 degrees centigrade has been chosen. Because water is present in excess, its concentration, which is 55.5 mole per cubic decimeter, may be considered constant during the course of the reaction. So as you can see that the optimal temperature of 55 degrees centigrade is selected. The concentration of water is extremely high in the system, so its concentration will remain the same. Approximately means CB, if we say it as B, so accordingly CB naught will approximately equal to the CB. And the reaction is first order in ethylene oxide, which means that the kinetics will depend on this, but not on this, and the reason explained because it is too high a concentration that it will not appear in the rate equation. So in the laboratory experiment, 500 ml of a 2 molar solution, 2 k mole per cubic meter of ethylene oxide A in water was mixed with 500 ml of water B containing 0.9 weight percent sulfuric acid, which is a catalyst. Temperature is maintained at 55 degrees centigrade and the concentration of ethylene glycol was recorded as a function of time, as you can see in this table, that from 0 to 10 minutes the concentration of ethylene glycol was noted, and as you can see it is increasing because obviously it's a product, so it will generate in the system. Now we have been given with three tasks. Number one, derive an equation for the concentration of ethylene glycol as a function of time. Number two, once we have derived that equation, we have to rearrange it to obtain a linear plot of a function of concentration versus time. And finally, we have to determine the specific reaction rate constant. So we will go at all steps one by one, but you have to remember the algorithm, which contains five steps. Number one is the mole balance, rate law, stoichiometry, combine, and evaluate. So we will go at these steps one by one. Now we know that A plus B goes to C. However, the system, or the kinetics, will depend on this. So applying the mole balance, we know this equation 1 over V dNA over dt is equal to RA. Since V is equal to V naught, so accordingly this equation will transform to minus dCA over dt is equal to minus RA. And we have already seen that part in our previous lectures as well. Going to the rate law, minus RA is equal to KCA, as it has been given that it's first order with respect to the species A. But since the species B is in excess, that's why we are not considering it in the rate law expression. And it has been explained here Because water is present in such excess, the concentration of water at any time t is virtually the same as the initial concentration, and the rate law is independent of the concentration of water. Cb is equal to Cb naught. Now, applying stoichiometry, which is building block number 3, as you can see, ethylene oxide, water, ethylene glycol represented as species A, B, and C. The initial mole for A is Na naught, for B is Nb naught, and for C will be 0. And Nb naught can be represented as theta B Na naught. The change will be minus Na naught x, again minus B over A, so B over A is 1, so minus Na naught x, and C over A is 1 as well, so plus Na naught x. Once you sum these, the remaining will be N is equal to Na naught into 1 minus x, Nb is equal to Na naught theta B minus x, N of C is equal to Na naught x, and once you sum all of these, N of T is equal to Nt naught minus Na naught x. We have solved all these steps in our previous lectures as well. This table was solved in our stoichiometry chapter as well. So we are using just concept of that chapter here as well. Now dividing whole equation by capital V, and V is equal to V naught obviously. So accordingly, this Na naught will go to Ca naught, and this Na will go to Ca. So Ca is equal to Ca naught 1 minus x. Cb is equal to Ca naught theta b minus x, or we can virtually say that Cb is approximately equal to Cb naught. C of C is equal to Ca naught x, as you can see, or that can be said as C of C is equal to Ca naught minus Ca. Now, from where that equation actually came, if you look here, Na is equal to Na naught minus Na naught x, or we can say Na naught x is equal to Na naught minus Na. If you rearrange it, Na naught x will go here, Na will come here. So accordingly, Na naught x is equal to Na naught minus N of A. And if you divide the equation by capital V, so Ca naught x is equal to Ca naught minus Ca. So accordingly, this Ca naught is replaced by Ca naught minus Ca. And theta B is calculated as Nb naught over Na naught. The initial concentration of A is 1 while that of B is 55. So the answer of theta B is 55, which is too high, and again showing that B is virtually constant in the system. So this is our building block number 3 for the system. Now moving on to our next step, which is combine and evaluate. So combine all these, minus dCa over dt is equal to kCa, because here it was minus Ra, so it is kCa. And minus dCa over Ca is equal to kdt. Ca goes here, dt goes here. Then we go to the evaluate part. First, we will integrate it from Cn to Ca and 0 to t. Accordingly, that expression becomes as natural log of Ca0 over Ca is equal to k into t. Then, if you rearrange it, it will become Ca is equal to Ca0 exponential of minus k into t. Or, if you remember in the previous slide, we have seen C of C is equal to Ca0 minus Ca. So, once we put the value of Ca over here, it will be Ca naught into 1 minus exponential of minus k of t. Or accordingly, we can say natural log of Ca naught minus C of C over Ca naught is equal to minus k of t. Once we use that equation, we will get the linear plot. So here our first part is completed, that we had to first derive that equation, which you can see covered here or probably here. And then we have rearranged it to get the linear plot. Now, because how we can get the linear plot? Because it is y is equal to mx plus c. This vector is y. This is x, which is t. M will be minus k, while c, the intercept, will be 0. So accordingly, you can see this plot is generated over here. How that you have time, you have the value of c of c. First, you calculate Ca naught minus C of C over Ca naught values. Then you take natural log of it. And once you draw the plot between time and this natural log, you get the straight line. And the slope of that line is minus 0.3145. And accordingly, since it represents minus K, so K is actually equal to 0.3145, which means that your specific reaction rate constant value is 0.3145. Per minute, because it's a first order system, so the unit will be per time, so 1 over minute. So this is the overall representation of how to calculate the specific reaction rate constant for the system. We will go to the Excel now. So now coming to the Excel, and we note that time and concentration data is given to us. So at time t is equal to 0, the concentration of the C ethylene glycol is 0, while the initial concentration of ethylene oxide is 1 for all cases. And accordingly, up to time 10 minute, the concentration is 0.957 kmol per cubic meter. So first we need to calculate Ca naught minus C of C over Ca naught. So that is equal to Ca naught minus C of C bracket closed into Ca naught. But now since Ca naught value will remain the constant, so we'll apply a dollar sign over here. And now simply drag it. And you can see you got the values. Now you have to take the natural log of it and simply drag it. Now you have to draw the plot between time and natural log of Ca naught minus C of C over Ca naught. And what we need to do, we need to simply go to this insert and draw the plot over here. And now right click on this curve, add trend line. It will be a linear line as you can see, and display equation on the chart. So as you can see, the answer is minus 0.3145. And if you see, y is equal to minus k into t. Y was natural log of Ca naught minus C of C over Ca naught minus k into t. So t is x, y is natural log of Ca naught minus C of C over Ca naught, and this minus m is actually minus k. So the m value is, so the m or k is 0.3145 1 per minute. So that is the final part of this numerical. So I hope you have understood all the aspects of this lecture. If you have any queries, you can provide your comments, suggestions in the comment box, and I would be happy to answer it. So that's it from today's lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on this channel.